Boy, I can't bear my excitement for our next guest.
Wow.
I'm so sorry about that pun.
Yeah.
We do what we do because it speaks to us. We write music for no one else but ourselves, I guess. And it's the reason why everybody gets into this, because they just love playing music. They love performing and writing.
For almost a decade and a half, indie folk darlings Boy and Bear have been captivating music fans with their signature sound. Constantly on the road performing and in the studio recording, they've recently dropped their fifth album, the self-titled Boy and Bear, in May. I'm at the apex, I'm in the strangest lows of my life. The lads are also celebrating the 10-year anniversary since the release of their classic number one, Harlequin Dream. And a decade on from that release, Boy and Bear have delved back into their recording vaults, unearthing a new EP, Lost Dreams.
Could you please welcome Boy and Bear's Tim and Kelly? Have you with us. Killian, welcome back.
Thank you.
The show. Tim, I think
good to be back.
Your first time on the
Thank
show.
You very
welcome
much.
To. You guys have done a bit of US TV in your time. How does it compare?
It's a lot of smoke and mirrors there. It's it's a quite a different experience. Where's the one in New York?
Yeah, well, unfortunately, we were in the green. We had to go back to the green room just before we went on stage, and there was a note written for us, and we opened it, and it said, "That was just so moving. Your performance was amazing," but we hadn't gone on yet.
Terrific. Did we write you guys a note before this?
No, I was a little upset.
Yeah, okay, yeah. I'll write one for you. I'll get it to you before the end. Now, congrats on the EP, guys.
Thank
you. Very exciting. Now, there's a bunch of tracks on this that I believe you recorded like 10 years ago.
That's right.
And you left them on a shelf in a warehouse. Like, how does that even happen?
Yeah, we sort of lost the sessions and the songs and the files for the album. So no one knew where it was, and we had talked about these songs that we knew existed somewhere. And we had to reach out to the people that made the record with us in America find it. And he didn't have them. And then he was quite upset at us, which I thought was ironic because he didn't have them. He put us into another person and they found them in a warehouse.
Amazing.
Yeah. How do you lose songs?
Yeah.
That's a good question.
Well, it's a lack
Aren't they
of diligence.
Last place you left them?
Yeah. We don't know where our first album is. I guess originally you had like a tangible tape that someone would take to their house.
Yeah.
And these days, it's just on some hard drive somewhere. And I don't know.
Do you guys need
cloud.
This?
Yeah. After the show, if I could take that home.
Right.
But I mean, speaking of losing things, like you guys sort of lost a shot in your film clip.
Yes.
For Southern Sun. What happened there?
Well, this record, Harlequin Dream, was our second, and it was probably our biggest budget for both recording and for video. So we did a video in just outside of Queenstown, and we would chop it onto an Alp to play the song.
Yeah, stunning.
We're singing. Isn't it amazing?
Yeah, it was beautiful. Except that the culmination of the clip was supposed to be the sun going down behind us, the chopper comes up, we're on the Alp playing, it's very emotive. But the director got carried away and we missed the final shot because the sun went down.
Oh, no.
Did he forget that was going to happen? Or did she forget that was going to happen? What?
I mean, it was one of those things you plan the whole day. They've got a schedule. But I think he got a little bit caught up with a particular shot that he was enjoying too much. And they were off somewhere else on another mountain. By the time they came back, our manager was pulling his hair out, being like, what have you done? And we were just laughing. You know, what else can you do?
What are you doing?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. Keep track of your songs. Have your shots.
That would be
smarter.
That's
what you can do.
You should have recorded a slightly shorter song. And you would have got through it
quicker.
That's
true. Yeah, it's your fault, guys. It's really.
Sorry, yeah. We'll work on that.
Yeah.
10 years? Since Harlequin Dream's release. That's massive. And you actually recorded that in Australia and not in the States. Why not?
I don't know how much we should get into it, but we had a quite harrowing experience on our first record. Yeah, we worked with a producer, a very well-known producer, who was initially a lovely guy, but it turned out that he sort of had a few little quirks about him.
He told us to go back to our island, and that's the polite way of phrasing that sentence. And that was day two with working with the guy. We're like, eight weeks.
Maybe he just thought you guys owned an island, potentially.
Maybe he thought we were loaded, and that's exactly it. He got it all wrong, you know?
He had this pulsating vein. that when he got angry, it was just like, go back to your island.
He saw the vein, he knew it was coming.
Yeah. But also scary. It would have been good to keep the beat, like,
boom. Music brain right there.
I thought of that.
Hey, is it true that you guys get songwriting advice from your dads?
Unfortunately. It's like, dads are good for this, right? Give advice where they're not needed. My dad loves to, like, he's forever been telling me, he's watching tonight, by the way. He says, you just need to write a song someone can sing. Dad, I've been trying that my whole career.
My dad's done the same thing. He actually suggested that he could write lyrics for me. He's been a chartered accountant his whole life.
I look forward to this album.
No, I think we could lose that album.
Boy and Bear's new EP, Sweet Dreams, is out now, as is the 10th anniversary edition of Harlequin Dream. There it is. Head to our website for all the details. Tim McKillian, thanks so much for joining us.